Hello, Dr. Carlo Oger here, emergency physician and medical director at Cartersville Medical Center. In this video, we're going to talk about some guidelines and suggestions for the advanced practice providers, APPs or mid-level providers, who work in the emergency department setting. Following these pearls of wisdom will improve the department's efficiency tremendously. First rule, if we're backed up, order everything you can think of. Getting seen by the emergency physician is going to be the rate-limiting step. And the last thing anybody wants is to, 2 hours later or even worse, be missing a treatment or a diagnosis that then is going to start the clock over again to get us closer to this position. Almost like starting from scratch and not gaining anything by that wait time. Depending on the physician, always run the case by the attending physician before ordering time-consuming and costly diagnostic tests like ultrasounds, CAT scans, and MRIs. Of course, a quick CT of the head, a quick belly can be obtained very quickly, and for very easy things, you don't have to run those by the physician, but just be considerate. Whenever possible, use order sets like chest pain or stroke set or site clearance. This leads to less missed orders that should have been placed from the very beginning of the patient's workup. If you order an x-ray for an injury, then you have to order pain medications as well. This is a core measure, OP21, time to pain management for long bone fractures. So if the patient already took pain medicine prior to the patient's arrival, then document patient already took medicine that excludes them out of the OP21 and you're okay. If you order a CMP, then order a lipase also. I see a lot of times CMPs being ordered, but no lipase. STD checks can be ordered in the urine and do not need a swab or a pelvic exam unless the patient also has complaining of pelvic pain or vaginal discharge or something else. This tremendously decreases the turnaround time because you don't have to do a pelvic exam on these patients. Unless you're looking for peritonitis, I see no point in ordering amylases. If you don't order an IV saline lock or fluids, then by all means try PO meds for treatment. But don't order piosulfran if you also order IV fluids or IV antibiotics. Unless the patient has a considerable delay getting to the back, then you can order the piosulfran first, so by the time they get to the back, at least their nausea has been treated and they can follow up. Always order medications for febrile children and order a recheck temperature when you do so. If you order nothing, then discharge the patient. It does not make sense that no orders be placed on the patient, but then they get to the back and they wait, and we end up ordering stuff on the back end. What's the point? If you cannot think of anything to order on that patient, then discharge them. Don't put them on the queue to be seen in the back and so on. And if you don't really know what to order, then run the case by the physician before you just sign off. For recurrent kidney stones patients, there is no need for repeat CAT scans every time they come to the emergency department unless they have a history of a few days worth of pain, which means maybe they already had the stone for a few days, it's obstructed, creating backup and things like that. Or history of complicated stones. Some people have history that every time they need to have that stone blasted or they need a stent placed or something else like that. So those people, it's worth always doing some kind of imaging on these. This also avoids cost and avoids excessive radiation to patients. If they need pain medication, then go ahead and give them a shot. Don't start an IV and everything else. Some of these patients might need a BMP, but not always. If they just started with the pain a few hours ago, the BMP is going to be normal. In general, don't order flu tests if you're not going to treat them anyway. If they've already been sick for 48 hours, then there's no point to test them because you're not going to treat them with Tamiflu. There are a few exceptions. For example, the teacher that needs to know because she needs to be out of school, or a nurse who has to be out of work, and so on. But in general, the treatment is going to cost about $80. And are you going to treat this patient if the flu test is positive? If the answer is no, then don't waste your time testing for the flu. How about RSV testing? This is only necessary when shortness of breath, cough, and wheezing in less than 3 months of age. Otherwise, you can pretty much assume that a new onset of bronchiolitis caused by RSV because it essentially will not change the treatment. Exception, do test the patient for RSV if you're thinking they're going to be admitted. In moderate to severe COPD exacerbation, you should get a venous blood gas. It is a great way to screen for acidosis and CO2 retention, but does not require a painful and risky arterial stick. KUBs. I find these rarely helpful. Do order them if you're looking for a perforated bowel and you're looking for free air on your diaphragm. Otherwise, if you're looking for kidney stones and you don't want to order a CT scan, or if you want to prove to mom that the kid is constipated and there's no other reason for the abdominal pain, or you're looking for a foreign body or something like that, but you should pretty much stay away from ordering KUBs. You should know your center criteria for the diagnosis of strep. If they have enough center criteria that are positive, then there's no need to order a strep screen. You should just go ahead and treat them for the strep throat. If you decide to treat them with PO meds. What's the point of a shot when they can get penicillin for free at Publix? Before you order, this is very important, a type and a range, check PCI under the tab that says blood bank to see if the patient already has one of these in the system. This saves time and money. These are all the ones I can think for now, but I hope you can think of more. Maybe email me, make some suggestions about things that improve efficiency by ordering the right tests on the right patient, and so on. See ya.